Let's work through a return on investment example problem. It says that Victoria Company has two separate divisions, Division A and Division B, and using the information in that table, we need to compute the return on investment, or the ROI, for each of those divisions. So we're given contribution margin, controllable fixed costs, and average operating assets for each of our two divisions. So here's the equation that we're going to use to find our ROI. It's our controllable margin divided by average operating assets. Now we were given average operating assets in that table, but we weren't given controllable margin. So what we can do is we can take our contribution margin and subtract out our controllable fixed costs to find our controllable margin. So for Division A, we take the contribution margin of $650,000, subtract out the controllable fixed costs of $300,000, and the controllable margin for Division A is $350,000. Then for Division B, we take the contribution margin of $575,000, and we subtract out the controllable fixed costs of $400,000 to find that Division B's controllable margin is $175,000. So now that we have the controllable margin for each of our two divisions, now we can start plugging things into that return on investment equation that we have there. So for Division A, we take the controllable margin of $350,000 divided by the average operating assets of $4 million. And then you can also see for Division B, we take the controllable margin that we found of $175,000 divided by Division B's average operating assets of $3,500,000. So Division A's return on investment, or the ROI for Division A, we get 8.75%. And then for Division B, we see that our ROI is 5%.